Since ancient Mayan and Aztec civilizations, human beings have known there's more to hot peppers than just their spicy kick. From medicine men to modern doctors, we recognize that hot peppers and the sauces we make from them can actually relieve pain. So, if you're a lover of hot sauce, is it because you like the taste, or because you're a pepper junkie hooked on a feeling? Are you high on believing? Well, believe this, there's a two-part process that spicy foods like hot sauce use to make us feel like we're high on fire. First is a potent chemical called capsaicin, and its partner, dihydrocapsaicin. They have no color, odor, or actual flavor. However, both trick our nervous system into thinking that our tongues have touched something scorching hot. These capsaicinoids trigger a protein in our mouths called TRPV1. Now, this protein signals our brain by releasing a neuropeptide called substance P and tells it our mouth is burning. To give you a comparison, it usually isn't activated by anything in our mouths under 109 degrees Fahrenheit. That's how hot something has to be to stimulate the same response as hot sauce. But when it's triggered, substance P tells our brains to pump endorphins to the site. Now, these endorphins are what cause the natural high reported by fans of intense hot sauce. It's a pleasant sensation, kind of like the runner's high reported by marathon racers. Now, endorphins like these also help pregnant women with the pain of childbirth, even increasing their soothing levels in amniotic fluid so the child itself is protected from birthing pains. So, in a way, eating hot sauce reminds us of being born into this big, bright world. So, if it can make us feel that good, why aren't we all hot sauce addicts, jonesing for our next fix? Well, it turns out you can actually build up a tolerance to it. If you're consistently exposed to capsaicin, it can potentially kill the fibers in the receptors that alert your brain. It's only after the exposure stops that your nerves can produce it again. Despite this, scientists are looking into ways to use capsaicin to manage pain for everything from shingles to arthritis. Which leads me to wonder, are there any other foods out there that take your pain away and make you feel oh, so good. Let me know in the comments so I can taste test all of them. And while you're at it, may I suggest two things to satiate your saucy curiosity. First, check out our foodstuff video on the secret of hot sauce, where my colleagues dive even further into the science and history of this spicy condiment. And finally, please subscribe to our channel. We'll never let you down.